Talk about class 3. We have been lecturing about class 2 in the past hour, but we are going to focus also how we can convert our cases of class 3 into a class 1 case, into a simple class 1 case. How we can change the scenario of a class 3 malocclusion and convert it into a simple case to accomplish. If we look at class 3, normally is a combination of a maxillary hypoplasia and a protrusion of the mandible. So what we want is to bring the maxilla forward and bring the mandible back. And the objective is to give an alternative to the patient to the surgery. How many times the patient does not want surgery and we try to approach it by surgery and they don't want, simply they don't want to go through. So here we have something that is real alternative to those cases that we can deal with them without the necessity of surgery and also without the necessity of extracting teeth or things like that. So a minimal approach to be very effective, not in terms only of dental, but also in terms of reposition of the relation in between the mandible and the maxilla and reposition of the feud of the beauty and the face of the patient. Now, it's interesting that it's an appliance that was designed for class 2, but we saw that the mandible has an external cortical bone that is very thick and has an internal cortical bone that is also very thick. So in between the cortical bones, there is a highway that is almost empty. And this highway that is almost empty makes so easy to move from mesial to distal the posterior segments in class 3s in the mandible. So this is changing the occlusal plane and is releasing the joint. Once again, one of the most important elements will be in the joint, at the temporomandibular joint, is releasing the pressure on the tip, on the edge, on the upper head of the condyle, and releasing this down and bringing back the mandible in a better sagittal position without the necessity of surgery and just balancing the relation. Let's see comparison of cases. We have here two cases, two young adults, in which one is 21 years old, the other is 18 years old. Both of them are class 3s, but both of them are completely different. One of them has a deep bite, and the other one has an open bite. This one is having an open bite, and the other one has a deep bite. So the question is, shall we approach these cases in a different way, or we will approach these cases exactly the same way? Well, the amazing part of the use of the motion appliance is that the approach is going to be exactly the same, even in the case of class open bite, than in the case of the deep bite. The major element that classifies or that establishes the characteristic, the main characteristic of the system, of our system, is the treatment of sagittal first. So first of all, we are going to accomplish the sagittal relation, and then we are going to work on transversal or vertical, okay? So sagittal first is one of the main characteristics of our treatment. Let's see the difference in between those two cases. This one has an open bite. Both of them, they have a retrusion of the maxilla. The maxilla is narrow and small, but the mandible is protruded in both cases. But in both of them, we want to make changes at the facial level. Which are the changes that we want to do? Well, if we look at the patient, well, in this patient, we want to bring the upper lip forward. We would like to bring the pogonion back. We would like to have a nicer supramentalis sulcus. We would like to have a nice relation in between nose, upper lip, lower lip, and chin. In this one, the same. In this one, we want to elongate the upper lip. We want to bring back forward the upper lip. We want to bring back the mandible. We want to have a nicer supramentalis sulcus. And the question is, can we do that without surgery? Well, we really can enhance beautifully a face without surgery. Orthodontics is very powerful, is extremely powerful. So if we follow beautifully few easy steps, we will be able to really change things and balance the face of the patient, but maintain the facial icon maintain the identity of the case. So the case will look the same, will appear to be with the family traits, but will be nicer, will be balanced, and will be acceptable in terms of the, okay? So, first thing to do. If we want to bring the upper lip forward, instead of using a vacuum aligner as a source of anchorage in the maxilla, we will prefer to place brackets from scratch and start aligning the upper incisors and start voluminizing, giving volume, start voluminizing and giving volume to the maxilla. So first thing to do is to place brackets in the uppers. But we see that in these two cases, we have a transversal deficiency. So the question is, are we going to address the transversal deficiency at the beginning, or we prefer to solve sagittal first and then we will solve transversal later on? So what we are going to do is to solve sagittal first and then transversal will be solved later on. First thing to do, we place brackets. We place the SLX bracket. The SLX bracket, that is a passive self-righting bracket, is going to help us amazingly in class 3s because it's going to voluminize the maxilla beautifully and it's going to generate the support of the upper lip that we need to enhance the beauty of the upper lip of the patient. In this particular case that has an open bite, it's not necessary to do any more than placing the brackets and placing a wire. But in this other case that was an ultra deep bite, what we are going to do is to place build-ups behind bite rams behind the lower incisors, so the patient is biting on the bite rams incisally in on top of the bite rams with the incisors. This will help us to intrude the incisors. This will help us to extrude the molars, and this will help us to elongate this lip that is so short. So we work on that, and once we are with the rectangular wire, then we switch into the motion. And once we accomplish the sagittal correction of the motion, we will exhibit the spaces in between the lower incisors, and we will exhibit a positive overjet. Now, the same happens here. Well, this is an open bite. We place the brackets, we place the motion, the patient has a lack of the molars, but what we do is to accomplish a positive overjet. Here, we have a negative overjet, but here, we have a positive overjet. Now, the case is suitable to switch into the next stage, removing the motion and starting what? Starting to place the brackets. So, if we go to this patient, now it's time to place the brackets. Now, we see that we have a nice open bite, but we train the tongue. Look how he places the tongue beautifully because he's aware that the tongue is the major problem, is the major problem of open bites. So we have to brainstorm, talk with the patient about the tongue, talk about the importance of the good positioning of the tongue for swallowing. So we end up the case with a nice and a correct overbite. But the most important thing is not what we can do dentally, is to know if with this position, with this counterclockwise change of the occlusal plane, with this new relation in between the mandible and the maxilla, if we enhanced or not the face. So we look at the face, see, and we see that there is a change in the relation in between the nose, upper lip, lower lip, and chin. The patient is the same one. The patient maintains what? Maintains the facial icon, maintains the identity, but we enhance the relation of his structures, and now he is much more good-looking. Now he is another patient with another aspect, with another, but maintaining the identity. That is everything is also a very important thing. So an open bite can beautifully be treated. We change counterclockwise the occlusal plane. We change counterclockwise the occlusal plane. And what we did is we brought this third molar and second molar in the place of the first and second in order to avoid the necessity of implants. But the most important thing, it was an open bite, but was an open bite in which we were very respectful with the roots. With the roots of the patient. Why? Because we always advise to the patient that the tongue is the first problem into the expectations into closing the bite. So if we explain that to the patient, if the patient releases the tongue from the area of swallowing, crunching, chewing, or paying attention to something from the front side, the patient knows that the tongue should not be there in front, then all our open bites will be easy to close and will be easy to maintain. But if we don't train them, all of them will be lost or will be impossible to solve, okay? Now, the deep bite, it's following exactly the same protocol. Aligning, once we are with a rectangular wire, we accomplish the class one platform. Everything here, when we place the brackets here, is because we build it up some bite ramps in the lowers in order to the patient bite on the incisal edge, elongate, intrude the incisors, and elongate the upper lip, So now, once we accomplish that, we switch, and now, once we already corrected the sagittal dimension, now we focus on the transversal. Now we focus on how to work on the transversal. So sagittal first. First we work on sagittal, then we work on transversal, and then we can finish. And this patient now is a completely different patient. The patient is nice, the patient is balanced, the patient is good looking, but one important thing, maintaining the facial icon, maintaining the identity. So we just balance the relation of his structures and the relation of his aspect. So this is the case at the end of treatment, and this is the evolution from a patient that was a class 3, short lip, protrusion of the mandible, incorrect positioning of the profile, and how we have enhanced the relation with a minimal invasive approach, with a non-extraction approach, and with this and that. But the interesting thing is that we did not extract third molars. So we were not extracting third molars, but it's interesting to extract third molars in class 3s. It's interesting. Always, when you work with class 3 through motion, one advice that I like to do always is ask to the patient to sleep with rubber bands when you switch to brackets a little bit to give a component of keeping everything in place, you know? So in class 3s, I like to use 2 ounces, 1/4, a little bit for sleep during the second stage of treatment once we switch into the brackets, once we switch. But look at the counterclockwise of the occlusal plane. What happens here? Well, the joint here in those patients, normally the condyle is up on the deepest part of the fossa. So it's locked, medial and distally. So what we pretend is to release the condyle down, leave a space here to relocate the disc into the correct position. Now, once the condyle is here, is in the wider part of the joint. Now we can move that back, and this is bringing everything in a nicer relation, in a nicer relation of the mandible and the maxilla. And this is what balances the relation. What relation have those two cases? An open bite and a deep bite? Well, nothing. Only both are class 3s. But one thing in common is that we are going to treat them exactly the same, with the same approach, with the same way. How we do it? Well, this is the scenario. She has an open bite, she has a deep bite. Both of them, well, in many clinics, they will say, hey, this is going to be a surgical approach. Well, surgery is a procedure that is interesting, but, you know, it's going to change the face of the patient. And it's going to go, the patient's going to go through an important procedure. So if we can avoid, in cases like those, the surgery, and if the patient is not looking to change the face, is just looking to have a nicer appearance with a better relation, well, we can change things. Things that we will do. In both cases, we have the class 3 relation. But in both cases, what we do is that in this case, the nasal label area is correct. In this one, is a missing lip, no upper lip. So the difference is that in this particular case, instead of starting with brackets in the upper, we are going to start with a vacuum aligner, with an Essex, with a retainer in the upper, with a molar hook on the upper molar, and then we will place the class 3 motion and we will correct. Why? Because we want to maintain the maxilla where it is. But in this one, we are going to start with brackets. Brackets in the upper, we are going to place the wire, and then we will start aligning the upper teeth. And this will voluminize the upper lip and will bring forward the upper lip, and this upper lip that is completely disappeared will suddenly appear. So now we start here. We place the motion. And the motion, what we will do, what we will see, is that it's going to counterclockwise change the occlusal plane. But in both cases, we start here, here, and counterclockwise change the occlusal plane. Hmm? But the interesting thing is that, and we have to see this as a normal thing, as a necessary step, in all of them, we'll see that there will be a certain extrusion of the canine. This is very positive because it's changing counterclockwise the occlusal plane and is inviting the mandible to be relocated back by pushing down the disc, by pushing down the condyle, releasing space at the glenoid fossa, this space that will be used by the disc to be relocated into the correct position, and at the same time will be helping into the reposition of the mandible to balance the face and the profile of the patient. So in this case, we accomplish the class 1 platform. Now, once we have the class 1 platform, what we are going to do is to go into the positioning of the brackets. We close the brackets, but, you know, open bites, remember, is not a matter of vertical elastics. Open bites is a matter of non-presence of the tongue in the incorrect position for swallowing, biting, chewing, and crunching, or whatever. So it's important to train to the patient not to position incorrectly the tongue. And if we train to the patient not to position correctly the tongue, we will be able to close beautifully the bite without the necessity of vertical elastics. Because vertical elastics are going to camouflate, if there is a bad swallowing habit. And if there is a bad swallowing habit, what will happen is that what we accomplish, if we accomplish it, that it will be impossible to accomplish, but if we, for any reason, we accomplish the closing of the bite, the bad habit positioning of the tongue will reopen again the open bite, and we are not interested in that. So we leave that to be closed by the action of the wires with the absence of the tongue, and we end up the case with a good relation of the bite. In a very short period of time, in 14 months, but we remove the 3 months that she was with the motion, so it's an 11 month of brackets in mouth. Today, the patients of today, they are only looking for short treatment times. So forget about having long treatment times because patients are not looking for that. So as shorter as we can get the treatments, better. And a good way to accomplish that in a short period of time is to standardize the process, to generate from a class 2 a class 1. And from the class 1, now end up with a beautiful short alignment because we move the case from a class 2 into class 1 with the motion class 2, or from a class 3 to convert the case into class 1. And this, once we have the class 1, then with the brackets, we end up in a short period of time with the brackets. But the most important thing, that we have gone from here to here, but we have maintained the roots beautifully and well kept, because we have been very careful that the major problem, that was the tongue, was removed of the area of influence. So we go from this to that in a very short period of time of 11 months of brackets, 14 months of total treatment time, and 14 months of total treatment time. And this is the patient. Working on the sagittal dimension and working on the repositioning of the mandible in relation with the maxilla in class 3s does not mean to narrow the airway. As we can see, we are not narrowing an airway on a patient like that, because we are not pushing back the mandible. We are not bringing this mandible and impacting it back. No, we are inviting this mandible. We are releasing the space at the temporomandibular level, and we are bringing the base of the tongue in a better relation. So this is not going to obstruct the airway. Once again, even if we work in class 3s, it's an airway-friendly approach that is working nicely. But what we do with the case that has an absence of lip, with the other case that is not an open bite, that is a deep bite, in the other case that is also non-growing, can we change things? Well, what we do is we start like that, we place brackets in the upper because we want to voluminize the upper lip, we place the motion class 3, once we accomplish a class 1 platform, from a class 3 we accomplish a class 1 platform, now we have spaces in between the incisors, now we have a positive overjet, now it's time to place the brackets, now it's time to bring the incisors back into a better relation. Always, in a case like this, that there is a lack of teeth, we always place mini stops in contact with mesial tubes in both sides to maintain the arch length. Remember, when we extract teeth in a maxilla, if we close spaces, the maxilla is going to diminish the size. It's going to be readapted to the new volumetric condition, and this readaptation to the minor is going to be forever. So if we want to revoluminize a maxilla that has been extracted with extraction teeth and we close those spaces, will never be again the size that it was, because the bone has a tremendous capacity of readapting. So at this point, we always will maintain the arch length with mini stops in contact. So we end up, in this respect, changing completely the relation between the beginning at the end with a minimally invasive approach and with a relation in which we completely upside down the relation between the maxilla and the mandible. We are professionals of facial aesthetics, and we have to be expert on what? On dermal fillers, on also balancing, on balancing the lips. So we have to be experts on give the perfect touch with minimally touches of dermal fillers. So we can really sculpture a little bit with a minor approach on those patients that did not have surgery and try to balance what? The beauty of the lips with a minimal invasive approach as an alternative to surgery, as an alternative to the way. So big changes can be done in cases like those. Or these two cases that are a class 3 case that normally, how many times we treat mixed dentition with the face mask? Well, the face mask or the reverse pull gear is an appliance that is bulky, and maybe the design is not for a kid of that has an iPhone 7, right? Eh? iPhone 7 and a face mask is a kind of lack of timing in terms of the of design. And this one is different. This one is a cleft lip. Cleft lip is another problem that will end up with a class 3 that will not be a genetic class 3, but will be a positional class 3 that will be also very difficult to solve. In a case like this that has a missing upper lip, and has this scenario in which we are going to approach with the same protocol in mixed dentition, placing the class 3 motion and placing something holding in the upper arch to reposition the relation between the maxilla and the mandible. And the cleft lip will do exactly the same approach. Let's see. In this mixed dentition, 7 years old, this scenario, we place the motion appliance together with a transversal. In those class 3 mixed dentition, when we say sagittal first, we say sagittal first, but we also mix up together simultaneously the transversal. So we work on transversal and sagittal at the same time. First appointment after placing the appliance, the profile completely upside down the relation. This is something that you will see in probably the 100% of the mixed dentition class 3 that you treat, that the change will be in the first month. But always, when we deal with mixed dentitions, what we look for is to overcorrect. A class 3, we have to convert it into what? Into a class 2. And if we deal with a mixed dentition of class 2, we want to convert it into class 3. Because remember, the occlusion, the anatomy of the molars on those mixed dentition, the anatomy of the molars is unstable. So we want to overcorrect to what? To be able to be sure that what we accomplish will be whole until the change of the teeth, until when the patient gets older, and this and that. So we start here, we keep going, but we are not fine here because we want to overcorrect and generate a case of class 2 in a case of class 3. And here we can see that a case of class 3 became a case of class 2. And this is the objective. Completely upside down the relation with a minimally invasive approach, with an ultra simple approach, but so effective. Imagine if you send this picture to the cell phone of the parents. Who will be the leader and the superhero of the family? You, the orthodontist. Why? Because has completely changed the kid with a minimally invasive approach. When everybody was saying, "Oi, this case will be for surgery in the future." Well, you can upside down that with a minimally invasive approach. In the cleft lip is very sensitive because this patient this patient that all the pictures are of the same patient goes from this stage that when he burns, he has this scenario. And this scenario means that he will have to go through many steps to arrive to the end of the process. So in this case, then what it happens to be is that at 6 months can be operated for first time of the upper lip. And before, it's impossible because they cannot do it at that age. So they have to wait at 6 months to be operated. And for the first operation, now that they do beautiful surgery, they close the lip. But the palate is not still closed. The cleft is not still closed. So the patient has to wait 6 more months for closing the cleft. And now, this is a checkup 2 months later. Then what happens is that the stages, the steps that a cleft lip will need to happen will be those ones. Lip surgery will be at 6 months. Palate surgery will be at 1 year of age. Imagine. At the first year of age, the patient already had 2 shots of surgery. Eh? Now, then it will go to the orthodontist for an orthopedic approach, working on the bone, working on the relation of the palate. Then third will be the orthodontic approach once the patient changes the permanent teeth, and then we'll work with the braces. Once we finish, once the orthodontist finished, then it comes the bone graft on the palate. Because the close of the palate here at this year of age was only of mucosa, was not bone closed. So then it comes the bone closing, the bone graft of the palate with an iliac crest. And not only this, later on we'll need a final surgery for aesthetic retouching of the soft tissues, the wing of the nose and the upper lip. So in a patient like this, when they come to the office, when they come to the office with a scenario like that, in which the patient has an impacted maxilla, in which the patient has a scenario in which the maxilla is completely impacted and the mandible has been growing abnormally into a mesial position, what happens is that this patient, you are not going to place a face mask because it's a kind of torture that you will be to a kid that has been tortured since he was born, right? So we will approach that with a minimal invasive approach, with the motion, we'll place the motion. This is the kit. We'll place the motion. We'll place a transversal. And now we will completely upside down. We work on that. We convert. Now we are edge to edge. The first month already, we can see a change on the lip. Now this lip is much better. Only in the first month. From here to here, but we keep going. We keep going because we want to exaggerate what we find, and now we overcorrect into a class 2, the case, generating positive overjet and correcting the transversal simultaneously, a little bit more, overcorrecting a little bit more, and finally finishing the orthopedic approach for preparing the case for changing the teeth for the new elements. And now, but the interesting thing is that the case now has a complete different scenario. Now we have upper lip. Now if we compare this imagine this x-ray with this x-ray is a complete different scenario. With a minimal invasive approach, with a small appliance, with just the same protocol than we approach adult cases, than we approach mixed dentition cases, it's an approach that is standardized, but is simplifying so much the process that we can really change the thing. This is before, this at the end, is the balance of the face and is the balance of the structures. So thank you very much. Thank you very much and hope to see you very soon. Hope to see you very soon, where? In Barcelona, in our meeting that we will do in September, that will be a fantastic 3-day symposium in which we will have a social program, dinners, dancing, parties, science, everything included in the fee. So take your planes, join us in Barcelona in September. You will love it. Love it.